Hi, it's Elsie. Welcome to my channel. I got asked how to have the character moving on the timeline. So with this video, I'm going to show you three different ways on how to create the progress bar. You can comment down below to tell me which one is your favorite. If you would like to see more CapCut related content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Now let's get started. First, you want to open a video that you want to create the progress bar. Then click on overlay, add overlay. Then you want to import a background photo. You can use whatever color that you like. I'm just going to use the classic red color. You can find red background on Google or create your own. Usually I like to have this overlay the same ratio as the video. So I'm going to click on edit, crop, 9 to 16 in this case. Then import another overlay that is white background. Zoom in till it's longer than the width of the video. Then move it all the way down to the bottom. You can adjust to how you like, but the goal is to have it the same as the red progress bar. Then you can click on splice to adjust the opacity. You can do 50. Then you want to adjust both overlay to be the same length as the video. Then you can click on the overlay, drag at the end, move it to all the way to the end to match the video. Do the same thing with the white overlay. Then you want to go to the beginning of the red one, click on it, add in the first keyframe. When you add a keyframe, sometimes it might resize the overlay to be bigger. That's why I don't adjust the size till I add a keyframe. Then you want to zoom in to fill the screen, just enough to fill the screen. Then you want to move it all the way to the bottom to match the length of the white overlay. Then you want to move it all the way to the end, add another keyframe at the end of the clip. Go back to the first one. Then you move the red overlay all the way to the left till you don't see it. This is when the reference bar is helpful because that helps you to see where you want to have the red overlay move to. Just enough till you don't see it. Then you can change the order of the white overlay to be in the bottom. Click on it. Click on layer and then select one. You can even delete it if you don't like it there. So this is the first style of progress bar. Next, I'm going to show you the one with moving character. Again, you want to open the video that you want to create the progress bar. For this one, the technique pretty much is the same except we are using stickers. Then click on stickers. You can select whatever sticker that you like. You can click on mirror to change the direction of it. However, there's a con of using sticker directly within CapCut. Let me show you what. So when you try to move the sticker all the way in, you can see the corner part of the sticker you're always not able to move in. Which means you might not be able to move the sticker all the way in. So what you can do is either to have the sticker all the way out like this and then add a keyframe. Make sure you adjust to align it with the video. Go to the end, add another keyframe, and then move this all the way to the end that show the whole thing of the sticker. So that's how you can use the sticker within CapCut. However, if you want to move the sticker all the way in, we can resize the sticker not to have it on the corner part, which we will use an app called InPlay. Some people might wonder, where can I download a sticker? Some people use the Jiffy app. If you click on search, you can search GIFs or sticker. just be aware of copyright issue on that. After you have a sticker that you want to use, then you want to open the InPlay. This app should be available on both Android and iPhone. Then go to Album and click on the sticker that you want to use. Then click on Canvas. You can select whichever canvas, it doesn't really matter as long as you don't have the sticker on the corner part. So I'm going to resize this sticker to make it smaller. And I'm going to have it in the middle. Then click on Save. As you can see, there's a watermark there. It doesn't really matter since the sticker will be moved down to the bottom and you won't see the watermark. Then click on Save to Photos. Let's go back to CapCut. Let's delete the sticker. So to import your own stickers or GIF, you can click on Stickers. Then go to the picture icon and select the sticker you want to import. And it's the same thing, make sure it aligns with the video. Click on the beginning to add a keyframe. Move the sticker all the way to the left till you don't see it. Then go to the end of the sticker, add another keyframe, and move it all the way to the right end till you don't see it. Sometimes it might take time to load the sticker and you might not see it. You can just move it like this and it should be able to show. So this is how you can use stickers to create cute progress bar. Now let me show you the last one. Open the video that you want to create the progress bar. This progress bar, I think, is more common in some of the Facebook video. This one is similar to the first style. We are going to click on overlay to import a color overlay. We are going to import the color one, which is the progress bar. And then click on edit, crop ratio to match the video, 9 to 16 in this case. And then we are going to add in a white overlay. This is for reference, so you're going to zoom in all the way to fill the screen. Align both overlay with the video. Then you want to click on the white overlay, click on mask, then click on rectangle, invert, and adjust it to the part where you want the progress bar to be. Click on splice, adjust opacity. Now you want to copy the color overlay, make two copies of it. So you can click on copy two times. And then move the overlay all the way to the next overlay track. Same thing with the other one. However, with the last overlay, we are going to split it in half. So it's about 5.5 seconds that you want to split it. Then move the first one of it to the next overlay. You can always zoom in so you can see if the timeline aligns. So we want the overlay to start in half. Also align the last one to match the third one. Go to the end. Make sure they're all aligned with the video. Then click on the beginning of the first one, add a keyframe. zoom in to fill the screen. Then move it all the way to the left and only keep the part that's matched the reference one. Then we want to add the second keyframe at half of the overlay, which is about 5.5 seconds, or you can just go to the last two overlays, see where they are. And then just move it back up, click on the first one to add the second keyframe. Go back to the first one, move it all the way down to the bottom till you don't see it. Then you just do the same thing for the rest of them. So for the second one, add a keyframe, zoom in to fill the screen. But with this one, you want to move it all the way down to the bottom. Then add a second keyframe at halfway. Go back to the first one, move it all the way to the left. Then for the next two, same thing, add a keyframe, zoom in to fill the screen. For this one, you want to move it all the way up. Then add a keyframe at the end. Go back to the first one, move it all the way to the left. Then for the last one, add a keyframe at the beginning, zoom in to fill the screen, then move it all the way to the right, go to the end, add another keyframe, go back to the first one, then move it all the way down to the bottom till you don't see it. Then with the white reference overlay, you can keep it or delete it. I'm going to delete it. So this is how you can create progress bar like this. Which style of progress bar do you like the most? Personally, I like style number 2 the most. I hope you found this video to be helpful and create some fun progress bar for your own video. If you found this video to be helpful, please consider like, subscribe, and comment down below. As always, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.